I still remember the first argument that my wife and I got into 15 years ago as newlyweds. We were in the car and we got lost.
Okay, I got lost.
But she had the directions and I was driving, and it was this moment of confusion and frustration. And it taught me three important things about spiritual leadership. The first is that we have to lead by following. In that case, I should have been following the directions that she was giving me more clearly. But from a spiritual standpoint, it means following the example of Christ. The Apostle Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians 11:1, "Follow me as I follow Christ." If someone were to follow you, if your wife were following your example, would it lead her closer to Jesus? If not, then we have to really do that inspection of our own lives first. Looking at, am I reading? Am I praying? Am I getting closer to Jesus? The second thing that moment taught me was that we have to lead by asking good questions. As she was sitting there with the directions, I misunderstood her because I didn't ask enough clarifying questions. And oftentimes, we don't know how to get closer to someone, to get to where they're going, because we're not asking good enough questions. We need to just be able to see, before we want to know where someone is going, where they are starting from, and then bring them along. And then the third one is the lead by serving. When you read the Gospels, what leaps off the page is how much Jesus serves. In fact, we see in the Gospel of John, Jesus washing the disciples' feet, the job that was reserved for the servant, and he says, "The greatest among you must be the servant of all." So what that means, practically speaking, is somebody else has a program on while that big game is on, giving them the remote. Going in and doing the dirty jobs that nobody else wants to do, right? Doing those things is what creates the credibility and allows us to serve with a heart that looks more like Jesus. And that is essentially what spiritual leadership is.